Welcome back, race of gamers. Today, I will discuss what is SoulWorker, and until the end of the video, you will know for sure what the game is about and if it is worth your precious time or not. SoulWorker is an anime-style action MMORPG, but not one of those that you are playing chibi characters. It is a proper anime game, and I really felt like a protagonist of one, especially that the dialogue language is in Japanese. Okay, so let's begin with the bread and butter of any game, and what is the most interesting part, and that is the gameplay mechanics. Be patient with me, because this section is pretty long. I really found this game enjoyable and I have a lot to talk about. SoulWorker starts with a cutscene presenting me the story, but more of this later. After that, I am thrown away into the game tutorial. Here, I am learning the basic button that I have to press for my avatar to start moving, to jump, and then I have to fight some demon wolves. I am being told to fight them without fear, like it was something I did my entire life as a teenager, fighting demon animals. Despite that, my character being an alpha male, I destroyed those creatures with ease. After I finish the tutorial, the game gives me that annoying present that I can open from 5 to 5 levels, the one where I get really overpowered items and XP boost. I tried them and the boss was no match for me, so I decided like always not to use them, and play just with what I get from missions for a proper experience of the game. This playstyle also gives me a boost of dopamine each time I find the gear stronger than what I have, and I think that's the reason that we play RPGs anyway. One thing that I have to complain about is that the gear is pure for stats, and if you want to change appearance, you have to equip cosmetics. It's cool though that you can craft them or do certain missions to get rewarded some. I don't really like this feature in games, because I want to look cool when I reach higher level equipment. I want to be looked up by low level player upon entering a city, to boost their motivation for reaching endgame, if they want to look the same, like I was thinking when I was in their place too. SoulWorker has action combat and feels really smooth and polished. You have combos to do and you feel like you are playing a fighting game. The skill animations are great too, and my character had a lot of explosions in them. Then, at higher level, I obtained a skill that charges and was like a Dragon Ball Z spirit bomb. Unfortunately, you have a limited number of skills you can use, but you can create a chain combo of maximum 3 skills and they have a little bonus from that too. Some of them even have a further customization, doing something different depending on where you invest your points. For example, I had a beam-like skill, and I could upgrade it to be more narrow or to have a wider range. Your basic attacks also have combo-like structure. If you click 3 times left click and 2 times right click, it does something. If you press 4 times left click, it has another animation, and things like that gives you a mini buff, at least for my class. The game is hub-based. That means the action is mostly centered in dungeons, where you fight some room of enemies, then you reach the boss. You'll have a lot of grind to do by repeating them at higher difficulties. The monsters and boss design is great too, and you'll have to dodge their telegraph attacks because they have different mechanics. Another thing presented in the game is something called super armor, where you have to break it before doing actual damage to an enemy or a boss. Crafting in this game is pretty easy too and straightforward. One aspect of the game that is aimed to your inner housewife is that you have a customizable room with a little garden too. Maybe it's not your typical gaming stronghold, but it serves the theme of the game well and you can use the garden to make potions for endgame. So, if something like this is important, don't worry, SoulWorker got you assured. Before jumping to the next section, support the video by dropping a like shield around it. This will help in the fight with the algorithm beast. Also, consider becoming part of my dream by subscribing to the channel. All of that having been said, let's jump to the character creation and classes available. SoulWorker stands off from other MMORPGs by the classes that you can choose, those being different from the traditional ones like warrior, priest, mage, and so on. Here, you have as protagonists people, each one of them having their own name and using a weapon that defines the class. I didn't saw any tank, DPS, or support role, but my class had definitely some taunt and damage reduction skills, making him some sort of tank. Another thing that I noticed is that each class has an evolution system. I picked Jin Seipatsu, a male teenager that was using a pair of gauntlets as weapon. So, like you already know, I prefer melee classes. After this stage, the next step is the character customization. I don't really have many options here, only some hairstyle presets to choose from, some colors for it, and also for my outfit. SoulWorker let me choose the voice actor for my character, noticing here for the first time that the game is in Japanese. Maybe you can change that from the settings, but I did not bother with that much because I was looking forward to use this preset, being a fan of anime and Japan myself. A dislike from me in this department is the gender lock classes, most of them being girls for all the waifu perverts from the online world. I'm used to this aspect in MMORPGs, so I won't talk a lot about this, but I prefer to be able to pick my gender. Let's talk about the story, questing, and the leveling progression. Okay, so the game has an existing story. First is about you being a soul worker, a person that has anime-like power out of nowhere, and you are able to fight monsters that are in the world. Because you are the main character, you have exceptional abilities and everyone is surprised of what you can do, and you are given a lot of missions. It's nice that the game has cool cutscenes and they are well voice acted, and I repeat myself, in Japanese too. It really felt like I was taking part in an anime show where I had to do the fighting myself. I don't know how the story unfolds at higher levels, but I think it's worth reaching endgame. About the leveling progression, I can say that it's a nice paced one, but a little bit boring with that much walking from an NPC to another. Also, you will repeat almost every dungeon on every difficulty, and that can get tedious as well. We'll find there some hidden quests that make you kill X amount of monsters by jumping attacks, or similar things in order to complete them. Off topic, I don't know why my character always told girls that he's nervous around them and can't talk well, but he can do push-ups in one hand with ease, also in front of them. Just why? Please tell me in the comments. Let's talk about the atmosphere and the environment. Here, I can only praise the graphics of the game. It is in anime style, but in a proper way, not like old-school MMORPGs, and can't even be called anime. One thing that I see in the starting zone is the Christmas tree. And because it is still present in the SoulWorker, I don't feel that bad that I haven't disassembled mine as well. The player base is still active, with plenty of players hopping around showing their outfits. The zones of the game are really great looking and the monster design is really innovative. They are not boring at all, and I was admiring a lot of them, especially the bosses. From what I read on the forums about the pay to win element of SoulWorker, is that the endgame task can be done without spending any money, but you'll have a lot of grind to do. If you can give me any detail, I am waiting you in the comment section. Okay, so before we discuss the pros and the cons, I would like you guys to drop a like shield around the video. This will help it in the fight with the algorithm beast. Also, you can be part of my dream and join the legacy by subscribing to the channel. This will motivate me into making more of them. Also, here you will find all sorts of first impression gameplay videos about all sorts of games, but mostly action and RPGs. If you have other opinion about what I said, or I forgot something, feel free to comment. I'd love to hear your opinion. And don't forget, I try games, so you don't have to waste your time. What I liked about SoulWorker is the fact that you will feel like in an anime. Few games gave me that vibe. The style of graphic and the Japanese voice acted cutscenes really helped with the immersion. The game felt pretty smooth and the skill animations were great too. The combat was exceptional and truly action-oriented. Also, nothing to say about map design and monsters. A thing that I have to say though is that the game can become pretty repetitive because you will do a lot of the same dungeons and a lot of talking in a small hub area running from NPC to NPC. Otherwise, not really have much to complain about the game, and it's pretty great overall. I really recommend it to you, maybe with a friend gets better. If not, you'll find an existing player base, so don't worry. So, in conclusion, the game is really worth your time, even more if you like action-packed games or fighting ones. That will be all for today. Thank you guys for watching and supporting me. See you next time. May the gods of good drops be with you in your grindy days.